This world, this planet, Earth, is a very beautiful place, which is full of amazing plants, animals, and landmarks. Some of them already known to us, and many are yet to be discovered, waiting silently for us to find them and uncover their mysteries. I'm going to tell you guys about some of those amazing and sometimes weird animals which I have found during my researches and studies. I'm not an expert, but I like animals and like to study about them and their secrets. I was skimming through some books about animals and explorers when I came upon a very mysterious and interesting section. The inhabitants of the southern reaches of Mongolia's Gobi Desert believe that there is a kind of worm monster which roam the desert. They fear this mysterious worm-like beast and call it Algoi Korkoi, or Mongolian death worm. Unknown to science, this elusive beast can be up to 1.5 meter long and can apparently kill either by squirting a little corrosive venom or using a method that seems to involve electrocution. The nomads tell of camel herds that have stepped on sand, concealing a death worm, only for each camel to drop dead as soon as one of its hoofs touched the worm. During 1990s, the famous Czech explorer Ivan McCurley led two expeditions to the Gobi in search of this dreaded creature. Although he and his team did not find a dead worm, they gathered a lot of data regarding this beast from local people. One of those data included an account of a party of American scientists who had visited the region many years before. One of the scientists was idly prodding some sand with an iron rod one evening when suddenly he dropped to the ground dead, having unintentionally touched a death worm in the sand with the rod. If these stories are true, then the only mechanism by which the death worm can kill in this way is by electrocution. To date, all known species of electricity-generating animal are fishes who dwell in water, a good conductor of electricity. By comparison, sand is a much poorer conductor. Perhaps, however, if the death worm actually exists and does indeed kill by electrocution, then it does not generate electricity internally but externally via friction. This phenomenon called triboelectricity occurs when the external body surface rubs against the desert sand as it moves through it. They probably have scaly skin and some form of reptile. I don't know whether they are real or not, but there has to be something which is killing camels and humans. There have to be some truth in so many stories and data. But whatever this thing is that is killing camels, it's dangerous and mysterious. This vast desert filled with sand is not the only place where mysterious and weird creatures reside. Let's get out of the hot, dry desert and enter the beautiful and deep water of the Gulf of California. Here we find one of the most grotesque and unique parasitic relationships ever recorded, which features the rose snapper fish and a marine isopod crustacean called Cimothoa exigua, which is related to wood lice. When one of these ectoparasitic crustaceans encounters a rose snapper, it enters the fish's mouth and steadily devours its tongue. Once it has done this, the parasite uses hooks on its underside to attach itself to the floor of the fish's mouth and, after that, serves as a replacement tongue. I was very confused and shocked at this new creature. We have seen desert and ocean. It's time for some airtime. There is a type of bird named oxpecker, which are renowned for eating ticks and other undesirable ectoparasites that live on the hides of large African buffaloes, antelopes, domestic cattle, and zebras. In 1997, Cambridge University zoologist Dr. Paul Weeks revealed that these birds actually provide a further, so far unsuspected benefit to their mammalian hosts. Oxpeckers are often seen entering the ears of ungulates. Ungulates are any members of a diverse group of primarily large mammals with hooves. Generally, these animals are those animals who have hooves, like cows, buffaloes. It was assumed that oxpeckers enter their ears merely to seek out ectoparasites. When Weeks compared a herd of cattle from which oxpeckers were deliberately deterred by his assistant with one that was regularly attended by oxpeckers, and he was amazed to discover that within a matter of weeks, the ears of the oxpecker-free cattle became totally clogged with earwax. Clearly, therefore, the oxpeckers were eating not only ear-dwelling ectoparasites, but also earwax too, thereby preventing it from accumulating. The nutritional qualities of earwax for the oxpeckers, however, is still a matter of mystery and debate among scientists. We don't know why oxpeckers do this, but hey, whatever floats their boats. These are just a few cases of weird, mysterious, and sometimes mind-blowing incidents. Today we saw the mysterious sand monster cases of the hot and legendary Mongolian Gobi deserts. So the gruesome cases of revolting parasite who live in the deep ocean, and finally, the oxpeckers who give grooming services to wild cute animals. I will find some more interesting animal cases, but for now, that is all for this video. I will meet you guys in my next video. Until then, stay nice and safe. Goodbye.